Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay. And swimmer's ready.
Okay. So survivors are at 1 o'clock, 150 feet.
Okay. Yeah, well, we have been carrying progressively heavier weather for about 12 hours before the capsize. And basically, you know, most of the night it was blowing probably in the low 20s, and so it wasn't too bad, but the seas were really confused and bad, and that's what really got worse. Basically, what happened was we got hit by a rogue wave, and it was just a lot steeper and a lot bigger than everything else we had been dealing with. And that hit on the port side and kind of, you know, basically knocked the captain out of the captain's chair. And the boat went up on its side and just turtled immediately. And within, you know, just went over real nice and easy, and there we were underneath the boat. So it took 3 seconds for us to be everything's kosher to everything's upside down. We were trapped into the cockpit. And the captain actually opened the G-curb box and activated the G-curb at that point. So, and it was a long swim. We had to swim down to get out through lots of lines and rigging and, you know, plastic enclosure and all the other things that are hanging upside down in the boat when it's overturned. And I actually tried to swim with my life jacket on, and it didn't work. So I had to take off my jacket and my life jacket in order to dive deep enough to get out. It was all I could do to swim out and get out with my life, much less any kind of gear or life jacket or anything.
Bringing him up. Easy right.
Okay, we got another still on about 5 seconds.
Want to pick him up?
Nope, coming here.
And it was a pretty rough ride out there because the mainsail had managed to unfurl itself and turn the boat into the wind, and so all the breakers were coming down on us. So it may be floating, but it's not easy to stick with it. I actually got pretty beat up because I was sitting in between the two guys, and I had both of my legs anchored into the outboard well, and those guys were, every time I get hit by a wave, were jerking me either way, and I got very badly bruised up. I mean, you know, Steve had been in the water the longest, and he was slurring his words and very, you know, blue and looking sleepy, so we knew he was in the worst shape of all three of us. So we thought we had maybe, you know, at most 15 minutes left. I mean, you can tell.
And this way he's going to get her hold.
Holding.
And I gave the slack. Forward 5.
Forward 5 line. That was slow on 5 seconds.
I've got the load.
Okay.
And taking the load. Got just cleared the vessel already.
He was completing the third voyage.
Jesus, stay in that basket.
Roger.
Stay in the basket.
She's staying in the basket.
Barely.